Tu vas aider.
Slide trying to bend the corner of your limbs. Getting look like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game. The run shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he coming a slide. Trying to bend the corner of your limbs. Getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk. I don't need talk.
Today, from Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, it's week 16 of the NFL on EA Sports. Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs taking on Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers.
The usual sea of red here in this venerable stadium has been turned white as we are high above snowy Arrowhead Stadium in KC. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Welcome again, one and all. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Brandon Gauden on hand alongside Charles Davis. And yes, the storyline here, the weather. Snow and more of it expected as this game continues. So how will that impact how this one goes?
Can these teams ignore the distraction and the strangeness of playing in a snow game? Because it actually affects the crowd as well. That big roar you get is often muffled when there's a snow game. And the second part, what's the footwear you got on? Does that fit the turf you're playing on? And how will it handle as things get a little bit slick?
Patrick Mahomes now in his fifth season with the Chiefs, ready to bring out this high-powered Kansas City offense for the first time.
And he just continues to throw touchdown pass after touchdown pass, leading the league here down the final stretch of the year. Guys will say that the numbers and rankings, they don't matter to him very much. But I don't know how much I actually believe that. Sure, he's team first, but I think everyone would like to see him finish number one, including himself.
23 yards on the play. I love that play, because in the snow, you think run, run, run. Big passing play there.
And defenders hate it, especially in open space, because trying to come under control, break down, and make a tackle in the open field, difficult.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas. Kansas City. Mecole Hardman, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs on just two plays have taken the lead. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Ray McCloud to return. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. Steelers here, ready to go to work for the first time. And the grizzled vet, Ben Roethlisberger, bringing him out now in his 18th season in the National Football League.
And I'll bet he's talking to his guys about resisting the temptation to try and turn this into an up-and-down game, almost like basketball, where both teams press and one team gets an advantage. Our team's trying to run with them, and they're just not equipped for it. Doesn't matter whether you're equipped or not. Just settle in. Get calm before you go for the big strikes.
Now the pass finding its way into the hands of Eric Ebron. The numbers from last week's game for Ebron. 8 catches, 114 yards, and a score.
And he's trying to prove the adage is not just how you start, it's how you finish. And he is finishing awfully strong. Takes great care of his body. I expect him to go ahead and put a capper on this season.
From the 27, Roethlisberger. 7 yards there and a first down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. A gain of 6 there on first. Working with a 2nd and 4. Play action, it's Roethlisberger. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 4. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out. Finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them, and we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
They give him 27 yards on the 3rd down conversion. So now 1st and 10 in Chiefs territory, down at the 33. He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4. This defense for the Chiefs, they were excellent last week in the win over the Chargers.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
Consecutive runs of 6 yards gives him a 1st and 10. Run with Harris out of the shotgun. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the 1st down run. He gets maybe 3.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
Dim's throw complete there to Johnson. And the Steelers are going to have a 1st and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. 1st and goal and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They hand this off to Harris. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal. So it's third and goal now. This is where the KC crowd can make it very tough. They'll try and run with Harris. And Harris is not going to get there. Great work defensively to stop him short. No gain on the play. And what to do now on fourth and goal? After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And Boswell's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a conservative decision there, but it does put him on the board.
And I know the players hate it, the coaches hate it, but sometimes you just got to take the points when they're there. Sometimes a field goal is pretty darn good.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches. And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Looking for Kelsey on the deep ball. That's caught at the 1. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Travis Kelsey with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead. Well, they had gone run the previous play. Nice little setup. This time they go play action. Defense bites a bit, and they hit for a big play in the end zone.
So they sold it really well, didn't they? Because of just what you described, they ran it the previous play, come back with the same action, and now they step back and throw it and get a big play for a touchdown. But what happens as a defensive back is your eyes have to go to the right place. You always hear Coach talk about, are your eyes in the right spot? Well, this time the eyes went to the play action. It froze their feet. They weren't moving. And he went on past them and caught the pass for a touchdown.
This fielded right at the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
The last run got 3. Now here. second and 7. Now Roethlisberger. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
On third down, Roethlisberger. And this is going to be incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Here's Hardman to return. A nice little juke. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield. Everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield.
Was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
On first down, Mahomes. Open man here. It's the tight end, Kelce. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Out to the right, here's McKinnon. Ooh, the juke. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Jerick McKinnon hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. They buzz down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead is up to 18 now. A drive there of just four plays, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken from about the 12. And able to get this out to the 25. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And this, let's face it, an important drive if they're going to get back into this ballgame.
Think about going into the locker room down 21-10. As opposed to 21-3. A little more optimism, a little more bounce around the locker room, a little more discussion about how they're going to finish this thing off. 21-3, I think discouragement clouds that locker room.
Yeah, and I think a touchdown much bigger than a field goal on this drive just to get into the end zone and get that momentum. 7 yards to pick up there.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
To throw again on second down, Roethlisberger, his throw incomplete.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away. The one with the dime look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
The Steelers send out their punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 46 on his first kick, this one in that neighborhood as well. Hardman on the return. 7 yards on the return after a punt of 39. The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have, and think back.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 26.
I'm seeing a lot of hands on hips in that secondary, and I suspect a lot of mumbling under their breath as well, because this defense has had no answer for the passing game here in the first half.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And he's got Hardman in the end zone. Touchdown, Kansas City. Mecole Hardman. with touchdown number 15 on the year and second of the game. And the Chiefs are able to widen their lead here in this first half.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Oh, how about this? No. Just his second miss of the year, and our score will stay right where it is. So with the missed PAT in his... back out to kick this one off. McLeod now on the return. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Najee Harris and the Steeler offense set to go to work once again. He's just been looking for some space. I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try to mix things up.
And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout. An injured player. Not something you want to see in week 16 or any week, really. We'll be right back. On third down, here's Harris. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. The Steelers send out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. He'll take it at the 42. Nifty move. So we've come upon halftime here in Arrowhead with the Chiefs on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. Some critical games going on as teams fight for those final playoff berths. Let's get you around the NFL here in a busy Week 16. We'll start our tour out west, AFC style. Denver heading to Southern Nevada to take on Las Vegas.
All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. Not much has changed since we left you at halftime. The snow still continuing to fall as we are back underway. McLeod now on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touch smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
On second and seven, Roethlisberger. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Jaron Reed in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Is the punt team now as this one sent away. And taken right at the 35. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over.
So first and 10. And if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
They run the counter. McKinnon. That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set them back for second down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And that is gonna be pulled in one-handed.
Wow.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I guess that answers the question of whether or not they're going to try to play conservative and protect this lead in the third quarter.
And I think this is something we're seeing more and more of in the NFL. Teams not playing to protect leads, teams playing to extend them.
And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
On second and goal, Mahomes. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. Noah Gray, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs have got it on cruise control.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. They find themselves open for an easy touchdown.
Butker on for the PAT. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Yeah, he's able to force his way through one man, but he can muster only about a yard on the play, second down. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Let's go, let's go.
They go play action now. Roethlisberger. And his throw is incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over
them. Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And that is incomplete. The Steelers send out their punter now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is fielded at the 27. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Check on it.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. From the gun, they will run with McKinnon. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game against them, but tally that one on the side of the defense.
Do you think maybe, possibly, it could be a little bit of a changer for them? Maybe not a game changer, but a little bit of a momentum one that maybe they can string together some pretty good plays and slow them down.
Mahomes firing complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 22 yards there, a first down.
And if anyone thinks they're just going to tuck their horns in and pull back off the throttle a little bit, you can forget it. Even with this big third quarter lead, I think this team's going to continue to take their shots downfield, and there's another completion.
Able to slither by, and down inside the 15 he goes. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. And the Steelers will take over here at their own 14-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice, because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it was a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there. Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. They lost 4 there, and it's third down.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on 4th down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. The Chiefs ready to rock again on offense. And, Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right? The best teams we've seen so far this year, the best games that we've called thus far, how we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions, because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remote. Oh, he fakes a spike. On the slant, he's got Hardman. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Now Mahomes. This will be caught inside the 10. Touchdown! Jerick McKinnon. With touchdown number 2 in the game, and now 11 on the year. And the Chiefs extend this fourth quarter lead, and they are getting closer and closer to win number 11. as that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. Extra point by Butker is on target, and that will extend this big lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Short kick. One of the up and now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Oftentimes when we talk about piling on in any subject, it's a negative. In this case, for this team, it's a real positive. Just scored. Now they go down, knock the ball free, get it back. They got a chance to really increase their lead and put themselves in the driver's seat.
On the other side, a little insult added to the injury. They're in a bad spot. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And they'll begin by running the option. They juked him. Now he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Patrick Mahomes, 32 yards. And the Chiefs are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Even though they've got this big advantage, Charles, they are not taking their foot off the gas pedal right now.
Well, I think what we're seeing is the result of all their great preparation and great practice time during the week. And even though it seems like this is a great chance to pull people back and maybe, you know, not try and score a few more times, they don't want to do that. I think they're enjoying what they're seeing, the collective effort, and they want to play it all the way out.
After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. To throw again on second down, Roethlisberger. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. What a nice little game. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. Now it's Roethlisberger. And that will be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
The Steelers send out their punter now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. This is brought in at the 21. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
35 yards on the return. Picked up some good blocks as well. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a 1st and 10 on the short side of the field. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off. He's got the 1st down here inside the 30. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. 54 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front over on that left side. Several key blocks sprung him.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage, and anybody could run him down from the backside.
And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game, defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead will swell by one more. One play, two plays, touchdown. That's all it took there. A very short and sweet drive that got him in the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Pittsburgh set to take over again on offense. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to someone else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. The Steelers on third down. A pretty anemic, a very anemic, 1 for 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. Chris Jones racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Gets past one man and running with power here. That'll go as a 39-yard punt. Give him 9 on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over.
KC's offense ready to take over. And this team continues to stake its claim as Super Bowl favorites. They are now eyeing an 8th straight win as they begin this drive here in the fourth quarter.
On first down now, run with McKinnon. TJ Watt in on the tackle.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Now it's 2nd and 9.
Interesting, Mahomes wants to throw it. And now he'll turn, and off his back foot, he'll heave this deep. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down. Mecole Hardman, the intended target, but now it'll be 3rd down. On play action, it's Mahomes. Open man, it's the tight end Kelsey. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. How about 25 yards on 3rd down? They'll take it.
Carter, I have to tell you, just one word keeps coming to mind from watching them this afternoon, and that's impressive. They have been impressive from the opening kickoff, and they haven't let up here even into the fourth quarter.
Looking for the end zone.
And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone, but could not hang on.
Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle, that evens things out, especially for a road team, especially for a team that's an underdog.
And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there.
75 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on 1st and goal. Here's Mahomes to throw. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that will extend this big lead. A drive that time of six plays, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Looking into the snowflakes, and he muffs it. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
Yeah, we dominate today.
The Steelers ready to take over on offense.
They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
again. No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
And his throw here is incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. Throw left side complete to McLeod. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So with the completed pass and the yardage they got, they'll decline the penalty.
So obviously, more yards on the pass completion than they would have gained with the penalty. They did the math. They did it well, and it works for them.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Midfield now. Here's Roethlisberger. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
And Kansas City's offense now set and ready to go. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes.
And this This is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Chiefs, it's a big win here as they move to 11-4 now in the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Cincinnati Bengals. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, this loss really hurts their playoff chances as they drop to 7-8 with two games left. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the Cleveland Browns. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon.
today. From Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, it's Week 17 of the NFL on EA Sports. See Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals taking on Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field, to the delight of this sold-out crowd, and they're all set as they'll match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. Again, everyone, I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left, Charles Davis. And Charles, you focus on this Bengal team entering play. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
And he comes to the end of the season leading the NFL in passing yards. And that's not necessarily something you set out to do at the beginning of the year, but it's a good illustration of how remarkable and consistent he's been all season.
They go play fake. Mahomes. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well, but that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out, finding guys who are capable backups who can step up and play when they need them, and we've seen the results of that. This team knows how to work through things.
A gain of 28 yards there, and give them a first down. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 43. Mahomes now to throw. He finds McKinnon, complete. And they'll wind up getting
bring this one all the way down inside the 20. Back-to-back plays of right around 30 yards, and the field position has totally been flipped.
This one was all about clearing space for this play to work because he's got to leak out of the backfield to his right, then angle his way up the field, and a really pretty throw to put it on him and create the big play downfield.
They'll run for the first time with Jerick McKinnon. And he'll take this one down near the 15. The numbers on the ground for McKinnon last week. 10 carries, 75 yards.
And they've already clinched a playoff berth, so I'm eager to see how they approach this game because some teams' philosophy is to go ahead and get guys out. Other teams' philosophy, continue to do what you're doing best. I expect them to go ahead and use their top guys all the way through this one.
And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and they're going to have a third down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. DeMarcus Robinson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories. And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won 2 games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and it's now a 7-0 game. That time a 6-play drive, and it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35. The Bengals offense here ready to rock and roll. Joe Burrow is the man at quarterback.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching through an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit good-naturedly, but they're letting him know you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, 2 touchdowns, 2 picks, but as you said, they got the win in that effort last week. Off the play fake, here's Burrow. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And they got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That one goes for 24 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. Had a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33. The numbers for Mixon last week, 13 carries, 69 yards, and a touchdown.
And when he went over 1,000 yards last week, you know what it did for their offense? It gave them a true identity because everyone's going to talk about this. The offensive line's going to take pride in it. Of course, the guy carrying the football will. But how about the coaching staff? When they go in and talk contracts, when they talk to reporters, hey, we had a 1,000-yard rusher this year. That means something in today's NFL.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. This defense for the Chiefs, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
In today's NFL, when you talk about goals for defenses, and you think that maybe you'd like to hold them under 14 points or so, we think our offense can usually get
under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Melvin Ingram in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Well, nothing takes a start to have a good drive quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
So that'll lead... And the Bengals with a third and long after that sack we just saw. Here's Burrow. Open man, issues Edelman. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
Sure. one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for three.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them three. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last two drives.
The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive. And as these guys interplay in Week 17, we know one thing. They are playoff bound, but they want to win that division title. They told us that is a goal that's been posted in their locker room since day one. They've got the chance to control their own destiny.
And there's nothing more powerful than saying that you won the division, because I know from building a team, when I talk with all the GMs and the player personnel directors, they always talk about...
That's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates, and he returns it into enemy territory down the 45-yard line. Now, after that last play, there's a Bengal down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Throwing now, Burrow on first down toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt. I know tight ends love this route because a lot of times they'll fake a block first and get a little bit of space and then come across. Because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer, he just dropped the pass. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A gain of 22. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Now it's Burrow, and that one going to be off target and incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Again, it's Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard. out there for the Chiefs. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
These guys had to settle for a field goal their last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get three last time. Three here, not the worst thing in the world. McPherson's kick is good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So the turnover leads to points as they add three there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice one for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know that are the best ones, the ones that really know how to lead their team, they tell them, that's on me. That's my bad. But let's go back out there and move ahead again, guys. We can get this done.
One good thing for him, it did only lead to 3 points and not a touchdown after that turnover.
Big thanks to the defense.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Throwing on second and long. Mahomes. Man open is Robinson. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Pick it up with McKinnon. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Here's McKinnon. Get inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Mahomes going to throw. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. Throwing is Mahomes on third. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. DeMarcus Robinson. DeMarcus Robinson. With his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Butker now to add the extra point. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. The partner just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season. The playoffs are not in their future. As they start to peer toward the offseason, what moves might they make?
I think the running back position, and I know we talk all the time about the NFL being a passing league, but the teams that run the ball effectively, they're the ones that go deep into the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. They have to upgrade here. And you and I both know in recent years in the draft, people have shied away from taking a runner early. But if there's that special one there, I say they go get it.
Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll make this a second down. Here we go. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Melvin Ingram, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, here's where having mobility sometimes can work against you as a quarterback. He thinks he can retreat and outrun the pressure. But that time, they zeroed in on him and took him down for a big loss, partner.
A really big loss. So that'll leave Burrow and the Bengals with a 3rd and long after that sack we just saw. Here's a give to Mixon. And he'll get this one across the 20, but only up to about the 21. It's a gain of just 3, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on 4th down.
Well, the guys who are paid to make the tackles deserve some kudos there, but I think they deserve even bigger ones because in that situation, they had to be thinking pass. Loosened up defense, going to pass coverage. Instead, maybe they surprised them a little bit running the ball, yet they rallied to it and stopped them well short of a 1st down.
It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Chiefs going to go back on offense here late in this first half. And with good starting field position and 3 timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. Mahomes throw into the hands here of Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a 1st down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. So we've come upon halftime. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. The final 2 quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the 2nd half of week 7. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football 1st here to begin quarter number 3. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football 1st to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Well, the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
To throw on 2nd and 10. Burrow trying to get it to Chase, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And remember, this is the #1 defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Butker on for the PAT.
It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. Going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at their 35-yard line. He'll hand it off here. This is Mixon. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Again, it's Mixon. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Now Burrow to Mixon on the check down. Nothing at all on that one. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Now it appears we're going to get whistles and a stop. A man down on the return. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The punter Bosher on now as he gets this one away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And, Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead, right? You take a good look up there, and you say, okay, what do we need to do here? Well, you're not in full-out protect mode. You want to make sure you run it, throw it safe, take some time off, and eat it up.
Not taking your advice, they'll throw first play. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And the Bengals are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. So they took their shot. It was a pretty good heave, but in the end, the free safety is the one who comes away with the football.
And two of the traits that you look for in a good free safety, range and decision-making. Both on display right there. And it didn't hurt that he's got a good pair of hands, too.
Now left side on the swing pass. The first down screen pass, good for five.
Boy, that one was well read defensively. And this is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
They go play action with Burrow. Dumps it off to Mixon. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
A 5-yard pass on first down and another 5-yard connection there.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Mixon with a first down carry. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and 9, Burrow throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. This won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, I was watching him in warm-ups, and he hit a 62-yarder that hit the crossbar and went over. This one a little bit inside of that, but not enough leg.
And the difference is what?
Well, your live conditions,
live
right?
Live condition practice where you just pop it up there, no rush, no pressure. I think maybe that takes a couple yards away from you when you have to do it when it's real.
And he takes this all the way inside the Cincy 20.
57 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
Now, back in my old days, before college, I played a little bit of offense. I used to love to pitch the ball to my backs. How about that pitch right on that play?
Yeah, going right. People run to the right more than to the left, don't they, in real life and in video games?
That is true. A lot of offenses constructed to run to the right side of the line of scrimmage. Those big tackles, usually your power blockers.
Logan Wilson that time there to bring him down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Still 9 remaining on second down. To throw, it's Mahomes. Flushed out right. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Patrick Mahomes, a 16-yard touchdown run.
And the Chiefs stretch this fourth quarter lead even further, and they are closing in on win number 12 of the season. So an important touchdown right there is now they're really beginning to pull away.
Yeah, and this was a tight game until not too long ago. But since then, they've hit the accelerator, and they pushed the lead up to 3 scores here in the fourth quarter, and I don't see them looking back.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead opens up now to 22 points. The drive there only spanning 3 plays, and it was all capped by Patrick Mahomes using his legs to get in the end zone. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The Bengal offense on their way out as we look at the playoff race in the AFC. And with a final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fourth.
And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Like a freight train there, Derek Nnadi with a sack.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury.
Got the quick. Get on the quick right here.
to try again after the sack. Burrow. And pressure coming, and they got him once again.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Now Joe Burrow on third and long. He finds his running back, Mixon. Mixon hit, and all the ball is out. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And he has brought this one back. A fumble recovery for a Chiefs touchdown.
We know this defense has some playmakers. We saw it right there. Well, really, we've seen it the whole game.
Isn't it nice to see that on the opposite side of the ball? Respect, my man. Respect. The defensive guys are outscoring their opposing offense.
Yeah, they're outscoring him indeed with that score alone. Butker now to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Here comes Darius Phillips out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. And as this offense makes their way back out, it's AFC playoff race time as we give you a look. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. Burrow and the Bengals with a 1st and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. This pass complete to Higgins. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards there on a Bengal first.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Now Burrow on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Boyd. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted. To the air again, Burrow. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So this defense doubling its pleasure there. Remember, they had the fumble return for a score earlier in the game, and now this time an interception return for another score. Butker on for the PAT. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. Harrison Butker, and a kickoff for Kansas City.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Cincinnati's offense coming back here onto the field. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. You're gonna see me in your nightmare, son. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And Burrow going to be intercepted yet again. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead will swell by one more. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception.
navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. To return it, Darius Phillips. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Ready to go on offense. Out come the Bengals. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. 7 yards, the pick. Fake to mix it and now look to throw. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Burrow on third down. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzomah. And he is going to have a Bengals first down. They needed three. He doubled that. He got six. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Burrow's throw here into the hands of Boyd. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Burrow to Boyd there for the Cincy first. Throw again. That's caught by his tight end, Uzomah. And he'll be down at the 46. Well, they go from 146 to the other on a pickup of 8.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon, busting through contact. Just wasn't a huge hole there for him to operate. Stopped just inside the 35-yard line. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for him. And after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions. And definitely not a lot of answers.
Now it's Burrow.
it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down, and it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Chiefs' defense comes up with a stop. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And the first play of the drive goes to McKenna. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Cam...